Yes. Okay, friends. Now in this part, the second part, we are going to discuss antigen-antibody and antigen-antibody reaction in the immunology section. And in this video, we are covering antigen. Antigen has two top properties, immunogenicity property and immunoreactivity. As it suggests, immunogenicity is the ability of an organism to induce antibody production, whereas immunoreactivity is ability of an antigen to react with antibody. Before going to the main course, we are going to cover the small topics such as haptens, adjuvants and heterophiles. We'll discuss them one by one. First is the haptens. Haptens, they lack immunogenicity. These are defective. Defective when I mean, means that it should lack something, right? Defective. So out of the two properties, it lacks immunogenicity, the first property. It has immunoreactivity. So it lacks immunogenicity, so can stimulate antibody production and it retains antibody reactivity. It binds to form either observable components, that is which is observable, which can see, visible, and the one which is not visible. It is simple and complex. The simple one produces precipitation, whereas the complex PPT is formed, whereas in the simple no PPT is formed. Of course, a complex one is visible. And when it forms simple and complex, depends upon the epitopes. If there are more than two epitopes, it will form complex. Now, what an epitope is? Epitope is the smallest antigen determinant that binds to a specific part of antibody. And the specific part of antibody is paratope. So I repeat again, epitope is present in antigen and paratope is present in antibody. And factors influencing the properties of antigens. First is the size. The larger the size, the better. The larger the size, more antigenicity. Chemical, protein has a more antigenicity, followed by carbohydrate, then lipid, then nucleic acid. Next we come to the susceptibility to tissue enzyme. Antigen is degraded by tissue enzyme, and when it is degraded, more epitopes are formed. So more epitopes means more antigenicity. So if an antigen is more susceptible to tissue enzyme, it is likely to be more antigenic. And latex. Latex we studied it somewhere before. We studied it in latex agglutination test for C-reactive protein. It was in the first part. It is chemically inert. Since it is chemically inert, it is used as a carrier particle for antigen-antibody reaction, which we saw in the latex agglutination test. And increased foreignness means increased antigenicity. Heterophiles. Heterophiles are nothing but, these are cross-reactive antigen. Means they react with the antibodies of other antigens. Now we have various examples in heterophiles. To remember this, I'll tell you a mantra. A mantra or a mnemonic to remember. You can always make your own mnemonic if you're not comfortable. Here it is. Heterophiles. From the files, remember the files of the office. You're working in an office. And you're telling your friend. Ree. Your friend name is Ree. Ree, I am. I am my very best. For SS man. You're telling your friend Ree that Ree, I am my very best for SS man. SS man is your boss. Okay. This is just a mnemonic, and from this we are going to formulate all this thing. And how we are going to do it? See here. The first one is RE. RE means rickettsial antibody. Okay. Rickettsial antibody is the one which you are going to detect. And you are detecting using protease antigen. And this is also called Weyl-Felix test. Felix. Do you remember the cartoon character of the Felix? It will be very lean and thin. It's a cat. Lean and thin. So from that you will remember the rickets. So it is rickettsial antibody using protease antigen. And next we come to IM. I am. I told you, right? I am. Re, I am my very best. So I am. From I am, you'll remember infectious mononucleosis. And whenever you will remember I am, you are a billionaire. So it is Paul Biller test. You will be a billionaire, right? It is a Paul Biller test. Paul Biller, billionaire, something like that, okay? Infectious mononucleosis. And it is, what is used here is sheep RBC is used. Sheep RBC is used for detection of infectious mononucleosis. And next we come to my, from that mycoplasma antibody. And it is determined by two tests. Cold agglutination test. Cold agglutination test in which you will use the human ORBC. Or Streptococcus MG test. And after this we come to my V, very V. V for VDRL. And in this you are using cardiolipin. And remember, cardiolipin is non-specific. And in the last I told you best. And from the best, best for SS-MAN, right? And by the best, I mean it is a universal antigen. It is present in all the organisms except rabbit. Here it is. Yes. For SS-MAN antigen. I told you, right? I am at my best for SS-MAN. SS-MAN was the boss, right? For SS-MAN antigen. It is universal heteroantigen. Present in all except rabbit.